Welcome to FFMC's online message podcast. I'm Pastor Scott. One of the invitations Jesus extends to us is found in the Gospel of Matthew. He said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Matthew 11, 28 through 30. So many people can identify with being weary and burdened. We can feel exhausted, worn out, worn down, and weighed down. I've been there, and you have too. You have too much on your plate. You feel overwhelmed. You face impossible problems and feel hopeless. You've experienced setbacks, disappointments, and discouragements. That's why Jesus tells us to come to Him, to bring all these concerns to Him. And when we do, we experience something only He can provide, true rest. He helps to carry our burdens. He shoulders our load, and He walks beside us. So as you listen to today's message, listen to Jesus. He's asking you to come to Him, and He's ready to meet the deepest needs of your life right now. Hey, I'm just going to take just a few moments just to share some a word with you. I think it would just be helpful for this morning. So time change last night. We're going to watch one little clip here. You saw a little brief snippet there from Kevin from the office. But I want you to watch this, and then we'll go into something that will be meaningful for us today.
Happy birthday.
Hey, it's
not a surprise.
This doesn't look good.
What? You have a cake.
You have a delicious cake with your name spelled correctly.
Told you.
You haven't heard our theme, though.
You don't hear a theme. You see it. Why is there a chiclet on my cake?
That's the best part. That represents a pillow or a television.
Our theme, if you will.
Because the fun part is you get to decide on an hour of television or an hour of napping.
That's our theme.
Cool.
Yeah?
I love it.
Oh, yes! Okay, good. So what's it gonna be, Kapoor?
Ooh, can she pick a half hour of each?
No.
Oh, then pick TV.
Take a nap.
TV. No.
No, TV. Watching TV at work is really cool.
Big nap. Nothing good is on right now.
Bonnie Hunt is on.
You know what? I have been watching TV all week. I choose nap.
All right. Okay, nap it is. Everyone out. Get out. We're gonna be eating cake at our desks. Let's go.
Surprise.
Move it. Let's go, 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 go. Come on.
This is for you, and happy birthday, Kel.
Thank you.
Okay. You've got 1 hour.
I'm too excited to sleep.
Just thought, how many of you would say, I would love to have a nap? Like even this afternoon, I would just love to have a nap. Now, the reason why I put it in this is just the question, but it goes deeper than just kind of a fun thing with Kelly Kapoor in the office. Rest. There's one thing to say nap. It's a whole other thing to say rest. And it's not just because we had a time change. It really is because of the things that really can weigh on us. There's a verse in a little portion of scripture that Jesus spoke. It's very familiar to many people. But boy, the depth that's in here for us here. I mean, this is it. This is from Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 through 30. Am I working here, Ryan? I may have to have you advance, friend. There we go. I'll just let you do it. Matthew 28, 18 through 30, Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, I'll give you rest." He's not just talking about a nap. "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I'm gentle and humble in heart. You'll find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light." Let's just look at the front end of this verse just for a second here. "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened,
and I'll give you rest. Let that invitation just sink in just for a moment. If it's familiar words, you have to really pause. If they're new words to you, just listen. This is Jesus himself speaking to a group of people that were around him in that day. They were trying to make sense about who he was, and all of them earnest in saying, if God is real, I want God to be a part of my life. But look at that invitation. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, I'll give you rest. No matter your situation, no matter the circumstance, no matter the thing that says, this is the weight that's on my life, this is the thing that I carry with me that my mind constantly defaults to. And his promise here today is just as true for us today as it was to those original hearers. Look highlighted, I mean, it's the same words, but look at the boldness that's in this. First of all, come to me. It's an invitation. And so there is an invitation for us today. It's to everyone. I mean, there are no restrictions on this. But then we start looking at the specifics of these two words particularly. You know, those who are weary, and we'll talk about that. Those who are burdened. And then there's a promise, I will, just to clear. And then what he says that he's offering to us, rest. When you think of the word weary, just think about what comes to your mind when you think of weary. Have you ever been weary? Sometimes we'll just say, you know, I'm just so weary of this. So when you think of that word, it's not a word that we use a lot, but it is a word that we're familiar with. Tired, exhausted. I'm just worn out from this. And the things that can make us weary in life, sometimes it is just that thing that just seems like that it's ongoing. There's never an end to it. It's just over, and here we are again. Here we are again. Here we are again. But the cumulative effect on that is it just says, I'm just spent. I'm just worn out. I don't know if I have anything, you know, any fuel left in the tank anytime that I have to deal with this. And many of you today, many of those who are going to be listening today are going to say, I identify exactly with that word. I'm just weary. I mean, it could be any number of things. You can say, I'm weary for the problem that I'm addressing. I'm weary for the concern over a situation, a family member. I'm weary because this issue that's in my life is just not resolved. I'm just weary with it, and it just has continually weighs down. Then the next word that comes up there, he says, and all those who are burdened. Burdened, I mean, we just think of that as just carrying a load, right? I mean, we could either picture like if you had like a heavy pack on your back that was just down, or you've got weights like buckets of things. I'm just burdened with it, but it's something that you have to carry, but it's not easy. So if you put those two things together, it just says it's just ongoing, relentless. I'm worn out. I'm exhausted. I'm spent, and I just have this weight on me that I just seemingly, I can't get rid of. I just have to keep carrying it. And for a lot of the situations, as a church family, we've talked about this for the last several weeks. I mean, there are so, and we're not unique to this, but there are so many big issues and concerns that we have for individuals and families. We just said, look at this situation. And, you know, without going into the details of those, they're big things. They're mammoth things. As we pray as a church, we're praying for the Lord to really work in the lives of some specific families and individuals, because the weight that they're carrying is so big, the effect, the toll that's having is so enormous. But to Jesus says to them as well, to all of us, he says, come back to the invitation. Come to me. If you're weary today, come to me. If you're burdened today, come to me. Now, when we sang the song, Do It Again, one of the things that we're reminded, probably all of us can say, there's been a time in my life when I was truly wearied. Where I truly was, it was a true burden. But one of the good things is we can look and say, but look how God was faithful. Even to this promise, come to me, you know, there's a time in your life when you, if you're a person that has a relationship with Christ, that you brought a concern to him that had been that kind of cumulative effect on your life, and you saw God work, and that's the confidence that we have, not just for our life, but as we talk to other people, like, look, I've been there with situations. I've seen God's faithfulness over and over and over again. When he puts the promise with it, he says, let's speak to the weary, to the burdened. Some translations will say heavy laden. But the promise that he adds right onto this is just, I will give you rest. Now that rest is this deep rest that God says. It's a peace that settles into our soul. I've had times in my life when there were things that were so big and massive to me that it's like, Lord, it's my consuming thought. It just seems like when I wake up in the morning, it's the very first thought that's there. As I go through the day, it's, you know, if it's a problem that needs to be solved, it's a need that needs to be addressed, a concern, it weighs on my mind. I'd go through it at night and lay my head down on my pillow and say, Lord, I'm finally ready to rest, and it seemed like it would be the thing that would be occupying my thoughts. Sometimes it seems like I would even dream about those things. And so that ongoing concern. But then I've seen times when I've come to the Lord and said, Lord, you have an answer to this. You have a solution. You have direction you want to give to me for this. And he has. And it's amazing to me when I look back on that, how immediately what he gave me was rest, peace. There was this settledness that came in that just said, Scott, trust me with this. I am at work with this in ways that you're not even understanding. I am concerned about it. You trust me. And over, God would say that same thing of like, your job is to seek me today. Your God is to trust me today. And trust me for what I want to provide for today. Just like when Jesus would say, taught us in the Lord's Prayer, give us today, Lord, our daily bread. Give me what I need for today. And so we see God do that over and over with his faithfulness. And what happens is this rest that enters into it. Now he does say, it's interesting in the promise that he made, was he says, take my yoke upon you. That, you know, that yoke, we know that's a piece of wood, it was a really heavy piece of wood, originally designed like to join together two oxen. That's what they were originally joined for. And the reason for it was for the farmer to be able to have this yoke that would say, I'm going to put two animals together that combined, their combined muscle horsepower can do the work. Sometimes you might have one of those oxen that would be stronger and they would pull a little bit harder than the other one. The farmer, you know, at that time would have to direct to kind of keep control because one would have a tendency to push more in one direction to the other. But the picture of it is, look, this is a shared burden. And when Jesus tells us in this for today, you know, come to me if you're weary today. I mean, if you have concerns like raising your kids, if you have concerns in your marriage, you have concerns with your finances, you have concerns about the coronavirus, you have concerns about anything, if you have concerns that are really wearisome to you, problems that are bigger than you could ever solve, if you're burdened, it's a weight that you're just carrying, he says, you come to me, I'm going to give you rest, and what I want you to do is I want you to now to be yoked with me, I want you to be joined with me, and I want to be a part of the one that's carrying the load, that's lifting that. The other day, last Wednesday evening, we were having an adult Bible group, and we're getting new furniture that's being put down into our conference room. It's a room down this hallway, and David Mullardy's here. He's one of our children's workers and sound technicians. David was carrying these boxes that were the frames of this table and everything, and then one of our boys, it was one of our BGS boys, Levi, was here. And so Dave said, Levi, help me carry these boxes down the hall. So here's Dave carrying the box. And here, you know how it is with the child. So Levi's got his hands on the one end, right? And he's helping Dave carry it. How much weight was Levi carrying? None. Right? Unless he's really strong and Dave's weaker than I think he is. But I know that's not true. So Dave was carrying the full weight of the box, and Levi has his hands on it, walking down the hallway, helping Dave. That's the picture of Jesus saying, take my yoke upon you. That Jesus says, this burden you're carrying, put it on my shoulders. And we're still carrying it. We still have our hands on it. But he says, let me be the one that shoulders the weight of it. Now, I really tried to think through this, and I thought, well, okay, Lord, do you, like if it's a sin burden, here's one thing. If you're carrying away, if you're carrying around this, I am weary because I'm doing things that I know God isn't pleased with, and I know it's problematic for me too. Lord, I know I shouldn't be doing, I just need victory over this. You keep falling into that same sin pattern. Here's one thing. If you're weary and burdened from that, that is a burden that Jesus can instantly take away, give victory from, and he can even give you victory. It says, we don't even have to go down that path anymore. I can give you victory over that area that keeps bringing you defeat. So he can completely take that away. If you have a burden that's like with a family member, finances, an ongoing health situation, it doesn't necessarily mean, he could, but it doesn't necessarily mean that Jesus says, you know, you trust me with this and let me put my yoke, you take my yoke upon you, and you know what? All of that's going to be gone. You may wake up tomorrow and say, you know, Lord, the situation still seems to be the same. I'm still facing those same needs or concerns. But God has entered into it. Now, here's the amazing thing. Sometimes what I've seen in my own life is God saying, I'm going to work, but I'm going to do some incremental work because I want you to keep trusting me step by step by step. And so all of a sudden, I begin to see a little change in an attitude of someone that I've had a concern with. It's like, that had to be a God thing because they would have never responded that way earlier. Or sometimes it's, if it's a financial thing, sometimes it's a little boost in finances. Some unexpected money came in or something happened. It's like, it made a difference. It was the need met for the day. So sometimes when we bring our burdens to Christ, there is the immediate, like, it's just taken away. And sometimes it's like, let me just carry the load of this. I'm in it. I'm working. You trust me. And that's what he wants us to do of like, God, I've got to trust you. I need the answer today. And God may say, the answer is going to come, but it's going to come in my way and my timing. You just have to continually trust me in this. So if you're carrying around a burden that just says, Lord, I feel like it has to be met today, bring that to God. He may do it that way, quite honestly, or he may say, I want you to trust me today and then trust me tomorrow and trust me the next day. Just keep trusting, keep trusting, keep trusting. I'm going to tell you, I've seen God do some pretty amazing answers to prayer. I mean, even just recently, some things of like, Lord, that was you, unmistakably you. I've had people texting me this week. We were praying about some concerns that were major concerns. One person said, I can't believe it. God came through, boom. And then I texted back and said, well, you better believe it. He came through. You were trusting him with it. So Jesus says, take my yoke upon me. He says, learn from me. Now, this is the interesting part from this too. It's not just him saying, you trust me and just do it. He says, and take it away. He says, I want you in this process to learn from me. Learn from me what it is to trust the Father in these situations. One of the things that he said in verse 27, Matthew 11, 27, he says, no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. It's not like that this is some kind of secret insider information, but Jesus says one of the things that we learn from him, he says, I'm going to reveal to you the Father. Not just this kind of genie mentality that the world has of God. He's a vending machine or something. He says, I'm going to reveal to you the heart of the Father. I'm going to reveal to you how God sees your situation. I'm going to reveal to you the promises that God has made for this. Sometimes the way that when we come to Jesus trusting him with the things that are weary and burdensome to us, sometimes the way he gives us rest is he says, I lead you right into the scriptures. You open up the Bible, you read some truth there, and it's the exact truth you need to hear for that situation. If you're a person that's not a Christian, you need to understand this. The Bible isn't just a document that's just full of just kind of history and poems and stuff that just sounds like crazy dreams. It's not that at all. When you read in the New Testament, you read about people that had real life situations just like you and your family are facing. You read about Jesus coming in and addressing those and saying, trust me, trust me, trust me. You read about how God worked and answered in very specific ways that would be just as applicable for your life today. And so sometimes when we're saying, God, I just need to know, what do you have to say on this? He'll direct us to a portion of the Bible that we read and we'll just say, that's exactly the truth that I need to hear today. Exactly the need that I need to hear. What will we learn from Jesus? And how does he reveal the Father? The last part of the question, because we were leading the promise we're coming to, is rest. I want you to think today, if you would say, Jesus, how would you give me rest today? If I could leave here with, if I'm carrying a burden, what would be the rest that you would give me? I think that probably the greatest thing that he'd probably do is just to speak to you that would give you the confidence, would say, I am in this. You have to trust me, but I'm in this. This is not new to me. You ever think about this? I mean, however many billions of people are on the planet that pray to God, and how the Bible says that God hears everything and knows everything. He knows every thought. He knows, he's so personal to us. It's like, God, how can you do that? My mind can't comprehend that, but I can't comprehend how supercomputers can calculate and do so many calculations. But here's what God will speak to you. All the billions of people that are on the planet, I'm aware of them, and I'm aware of you, and I know you intimately, and I know your situation intimately. And I am a God that can do beyond anything you can even begin to comprehend. And I can direct people and courses and resources. I have everything at my disposal. Whatever I do is going to bring honor to me, so it's clear that this is me doing it and clear that it fits within who I am and how I've revealed myself in the Bible. But part of as you leave today, if you say, God, what's the rest? He's going to say, I want you to trust me and listen to see if I'm speaking. And let, as you comprehend, even if he just says, I'm in it, I hear you, I'm aware, trust me. And every time you start to get anxious about it, trust me with it, trust me with it, trust me with it. Let his peace settle back into you. Jesus said that his yoke was easy. Sometimes following Jesus isn't easy, just to be honest, because the things that he'll call us to could be challenging. But the reason that it's easy is if we come into this place of surrender that says, Jesus, you are who you say you are. You truly are who you say you are. You truly do have all the power. All the glory is yours. The more that I understand who Jesus is, the more I understand what he's already done for me by his death on the cross to forgive my sins, the more I understand that he says that I want to give you an abundant life now, the more that I understand the promises that he has for me when this life is over, the more that I understand those things, the easier it is then to say, God, even if I have to go through some rough waters, I'm going to trust you. And then there's just the ease of, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to just have a confidence in you. He says, my burden is light. It's not lots of rule keeping. It's not lots of stuff you have to jump through and hoops you have to do. He said, no, it's just a simple matter of trust and conversation. When you pray, you just talk to God, just the way we're talking now. If your person says, I really don't know how to pray, yeah, you do. You know how to talk. So if you have a prayer concern, if you've got a burden, like you say, you know, God, this is a problem. It keeps me up at night. I don't know what to do. I'm trying to find a solution. God, I need your help. That's a great prayer. It goes full circle back to where we are, the invitation, where he just said, come to me. And I wanted to give an opportunity for that for us all this morning. I guarantee you that there are going to be people here. We're not going to have you raise your hands or do anything, you know, so we could see it. But I guarantee if I ask the question, how many of you are weary today with something? Hands would go up. How many of you have a true burden, a load you're carrying? I guarantee hands would go up. And so Jesus says to you and to all of us, then I want you to come to me. I want you to let me be yoked with you. I want you to understand how I can enter into and carry this burden. I want you to learn from me. I want you to allow me to give you the rest that your heart needs. But it starts by you coming to him. And we're going to do that through prayer. So what I'm going to do, just to close out my time, and then we're almost done, is just to leave you just in a prayer. And your response to this, now this is the critical part. If you are responding back to God in prayer, tell him so in prayer. But this is important for you as well as for us. As soon as we're done, Pastor Michael is going to come back. He's going to say some words about our connection card. It's important if you say, I'm trusting God with something, to have a little action step with that. And the simplest way we do that is for you to take that connection card and say, I'm trusting God with this situation. You can write a little prayer note on there. Please pray for me for a burden I'm carrying. We'll pray for you. If you're saying, I'm accepting Christ as my Savior, I want to put my confidence in him to have him be a part of my life, let us know that. That's important for you too, because it's that little concrete action that goes beyond just the prayer that you're making. So let me pray, and then we'll conclude this time. Jesus, I thank you that as we've heard your truth today, what a wonderful promise to come to me if you're weary with something, if you're just worn out with the concern of it, if you are burdened, you are just carrying a load today, that you've made this promise, look, come to me, let me help shoulder that, and I'll give you the rest you're looking for. I'll put the peace in your heart that you need today. And so, Father, I pray today for those persons that are saying, Jesus, I am weary, I am burdened, and I'm bringing it to you. Lord, give me that rest that you promise. Reveal to me more about God. I want to grow in my knowledge of God. I want to trust God every day. I want you to be a part of these things each and every day. And so, Jesus, I'm coming in. My faith is just because I'm praying to you. So, Lord, hear my prayer. And work and answer according to your promise. And Jesus, that's what I pray exactly that you would do, that you would hear my prayer, and that you would work according to your promise. Lord, thank you for allowing us to come out today. Bless us as we continue on this gorgeous day you've given us, I pray.